Hi everybody, it's Mr. Pollard. In this lab video, I'll be performing an experiment to combine magnesium with chlorine in order to determine the ratio at which they combine. So we're basically trying to answer this question: when magnesium and chlorine react, what is the ratio of magnesium to chloride ions? The next step in our lab is to measure the masses of a few materials. First, I'm going to measure the mass of that magnesium ribbon. So we can see that the magnesium ribbon has a mass of 0.22 grams. Next, I'm going to measure the mass of a 100 mil graduated cylinder and a watch glass. I'll put those together. We'll just put those up here and measure their mass combined. Looks like we have a mass of 77.74 grams for the beaker and the watch glass. For the next step of the experiment, I'll put the magnesium ribbon into the beaker, and I'm going to add 25 milliliters of that 1 molar hydrochloric acid. So we can see a lot of evidence of chemical change here. We're seeing bubbling, fizzing, and that is a result of the magnesium ribbon reacting with the hydrochloric acid. Now I want to let this go until the reaction is fully complete. I'm going to know it's done when there's no more visible magnesium ribbon left in the beaker and there's no more evidence of any bubbling or fizzing from the reaction. So this reaction is almost done, but I can see that there's a little bit of magnesium ribbon just floating near the top. You can see it moving around on the surface there. So I want to just give this a little bit of a swirl to move around the liquid and move that magnesium just to encourage the reaction to go to completion. All right, so now we can see that that reaction has gone to completion. I don't see any more magnesium ribbon. That means that the magnesium has reacted with the hydrochloric acid. Now what happens here in this reaction is we form a salt, magnesium chloride, which is water soluble. So that hydrochloric acid that we're using is hydrogen chloride dissolved in water. The salt, magnesium chloride, that forms is going to be dissolved in the water. So we don't see it, but it's in there. So how are we going to see it? How are we going to measure it? We want to heat this beaker now to drive off the water. That should leave behind the magnesium chloride salt. So I want to move this over to the fume hood. There's a possibility that there is some unreacted hydrochloric acid still in the beaker. So when we heat this, if there's unreacted hydrochloric acid, that could go into the air, and that's not something that we'd want to breathe in. So I'm going to go ahead and place this beaker with a watch glass on top just to control any spattering. And I'm going to go ahead and start heating this. Put it at about a 6 or a 7 setting. And then I'm just going to go ahead and close the fume hood and turn on the blower. All right, so here we can see that the amount of liquid that's left in the beaker is pretty small. So pretty soon what we're gonna see with these bubbles, and I wanna turn down the heat here even more, is that the bubbles are going to start to almost look more viscous, and they're going to start to look kind of crusty. So let's watch for that. Okay, so we're getting really close now. The amount of liquid that's left in the beaker is very, very small. We're starting to see kind of a more whitish color, and we're seeing that the bubbles are more viscous looking, and real soon we're going to start to see evidence of that salt. A little bit of popping, that's why we have the watch glass on top, just to avoid anything from spattering out of the beaker as we heat this. All right, so here we go. That liquid is being driven off. What we're left, what we see left behind inside of the beaker is a white crystalline material. That is the magnesium chloride. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and turn off the beaker I'm sorry, I'll turn off the hot plate, which is heating the beaker, and we're going to let this sit overnight. Tomorrow we're going to do some additional heating just to make sure that we get our salt sample as dry as we can possibly get it. All right, so here we're looking at our sample of magnesium chloride, which has sat overnight, so it looks to be pretty dry. Let's go ahead and take a look on the inside here. You can see that there's a white solid material that's formed in the bottom of the beaker after we heated the beaker and drove off all the water. So let's get a mass measurement of this sample. We will mass the sample together with the beaker and the watch glass. So we're getting a mass of 78.84 grams. Now we want to verify that this is a dry sample, so we're going to go ahead and heat the beaker for a little bit longer just to make sure that there's no additional water hiding out in the salt. All right, we're going to do one more mass measurement of our magnesium chloride sample. So let's go ahead and make sure this is zeroed. Take our sample. And we're getting a mass of 78.57. All right, so now we've completed the magnesium chloride lab, and remember, we were reacting magnesium with hydrochloric acid to produce a salt, magnesium chloride, and I'll let you go ahead and see what that looks like here. So we see that the magnesium chloride is a white crystalline material, and the data for that experiment turned out to be really good data. We started out with a mass of 0.22 grams of magnesium. Then we added in some hydrochloric acid. The magnesium reacted, producing the magnesium chloride, but it was dissolved in a bunch of water, so we had to heat the water to get rid of all the water and to try to dry the salt. Now, the watch glass and the beaker by themselves had a mass of 77.74 grams. Now, massing this with the watch glass, the beaker, and the salt inside, there was a mass of 78.57 grams. So I can subtract and find the mass of that magnesium chloride salt. And what I found was that there was a mass of 0.83 grams. Now, by subtraction, I know that there were 0.22 grams of magnesium, 0.83 grams of magnesium chloride. So by subtraction, I can find the mass of the additional chlorine, which worked out to be 0.61 grams.